In this session, we are going to discuss about the difference between the structure and array. So already we know that what is an array. Array is nothing but a collection of similar elements of the same data type. So similar, nothing but a continuous memory location of the homogeneous element. So I can say that here similar elements. Similar collection of similar elements. So in structure, collection of different different data types of elements. So here array is nothing but a collection of similar elements. So structure is nothing but a collection of different types of data types of an element. Next, come to the keyword. So whether we use any keyword to the arrays, definitely there is no keyword. We are not using to define the arrays. So whether we require to use any keyword for the structure, yes, we need to use a keyword for the structure, that is called a struct. So we are using the keyword called a struct to define the structure. So for arrays, there is no keyword to define the arrays. Now, so what is the declaration of a arrays here? So we require, what is the declaration? We require the data type, array variable name. So example, integer, array variable is a of size equal to 5. So means what will happen in this variable, we can store only 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. So means, so 1, 2, 3, 4 are the similar elements of same data type. So that is called an array. So what is the declaration of the structure? So when you use the struct, okay, when you use the struct and the structure name. Here, different data members we need to use. Data members. And every structure must end with a semicolon. Now, example, struct ABC, int A, float B, char C. So here we are using the keyword called struct. Okay, what is the structure name? Structure name is ABC. Different data members. One is the A, its type is integer, B is type is float, C is type of character. So this is the way of declaration. So how to initialize, how to access the elements of a structure? So by using the reference index numbers. Now, so if you want to access number 3, so what will happen? These data are going to be stored in the location called 1, 2, 3, and 5. Now I want to access the element equal to 4. So what is the index number we need to use here? We need to use index number A of 3. Now what will happen? If I use the A of 3, it is going to be fetched or it is going to be initialized the number 4, or we can access the data of 4 of this reference index number. If you want to access the data of A or B of any structure member of ABC, what you have to use? So here we are going to use the dot operator. So by using dot operator, we are going to fetch or initialize the data members of a structure. So how to access the members of a structure? Simple, abc dot b, so abc dot c, Like this we can access. Suppose if you having a equal to, if a equal to 10, b equal to 20.5, c equal to a, like this we having here. Now what will happen? If I use abc dot a, it is going to be fetched. Then data equal to what here? 10. If I use abc dot b, nothing but it is going to be print 20.5. If I use abc dot c, then it is going to print a. Means what you understood here? If you want to access the data of a arrays, we need to use the reference index numbers. If you want to access the data of a structure, we are going to use the dot operators. So here, that is the major difference between the arrays and structure. Come to the memory location. So what will happen? So array will have a continuous memory location of different elements, nothing but similar elements. So continuous memory location. Example, suppose we having 5 elements in the array of index number 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here we having elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is the base address of this index number is? Let us assume that 100. There is 102. This is 104, 106, 108. Means, so here the data is going to be arranged in a continuous memory location. Now, what will happen here? So one element is going to be stored in the 100. Element number 2 is going to be stored in the location 102. Means I can say here, these are having the continuous memory location. So because of each block is going to be occupied how many bytes? 2 bytes. When having the type equal to integer. Now come to the structure. Structure will have a unit of memory location. Now what will happen? So this A will have how many bytes? 2 bytes. This float will have 4 bytes. This character will have 1 byte. Now our total bytes is how much here? Total bytes is 7. So whenever we create a structure variable, now what is the variable here? What is the structure name here? Structure name is ABC. Okay, now we need to create a variable. So variable name is V1. Let us in that V1. So whenever we create a variable 1, now what will happen? The memory allocated for V1 of how many bytes? Of how many bytes required here? 7 bytes is required. Now 7 bytes is required. 7 bytes of memory allocation done to whom? To V1 of to whom? By 2 bytes for A, okay, 4 bytes for B and 1 byte for 1. So now what will happen here? A occupy the 2 bytes, B occupy the 4 bytes, C occupy the 1 byte. So in a arrays what will happen? So each element will have the same size of memory location. In a structure, it is depend upon the data types. Okay, if you are using different character arrays, if you are using integer array, if you are using the float or different data types, that depends upon the data type. So those data types are going to be make as a one unit. That one unit is going to be shared the all the member of the structures. So what is the first difference? Difference is the definition. That is, the arrays are nothing but collection of similar elements. So structure is nothing but collection of different data types of the elements. Now, so we use any keyword in the arrays? Definitely not. So in the structure, we are going to use the keyword called struct. So we are going to use the keyword called struct. Next, what is the declaration? How to declare a variable of array? Data type, array variable name. Example, integer a of 5. We are giving the similar elements like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of same data type as a integer. Now, here we are creating the struct. But how to create a structure? By using the keyword called struct and structure name, different data type members. Example, struct abc int a equal to 10, float b equal to 20, c equal to character, c equal to a. Now we create a variable called v1. Whenever we create a variable v1, then what will happen? All these members of structure got memory allocation in combinedly. Now what will happen here? Initialization and accessing the elements. How to access and how to initialize the elements into the array? By using a reference index number. So how to use the reference index number? What is reference index number? Reference index number is nothing but array variable name and index number. Array variable name and index number will act as a reference index number. So how to access the members of a structure? By using the dot operator. I hope this you understood the session. Thank you.